What's up, everybody? It's Two Cold Cuts, and today I'm going to be showing you how to do this look and style step-by-step process with using the JRL Fresh Fade 1040 and JRL Fresh Fade 1050. First, I'm going to take my Hunter 1114 trimmers and quickly line him up. I'm only using the edge of the trimmer blade rather than using the entire blade. And when I do the hook, I'm going to start from the bottom going up. Next, I'm going to put the part in, and I'm going to start by simply drawing it in. So right now I'm just going to use the corner of the blade again rather than the entire blade and just draw it right in. Take my JRL Fresh Fade 1050 trimmers, and now I'm just going to make the line a little bit more precise. I'm going to go in again just using the corner of the blade. I don't really want to use the entire blade, that way I stay more in control of the line. The Fresh Fade 1050 has three speed settings: low, medium, and high. At the highest speed setting, you have a runtime of 70 minutes, and at the lowest speed setting, you have a runtime of 90 minutes. Take my Hunter 1114 clippers, which have a fade blade on it. Now the fade blade is a little bit different than our taper blade. The fade blade has a curved edge to it, and it's about 20% sharper than our taper blade, and that's what makes it the perfect blade to bald with. Now I'm going to use my JRL Fresh Fade 1040s. It has the taper blade on it, and I have the lever open, and now I'm going to begin my fade. Using the C-stroke motion so I don't leave behind too harsh of a half line. Now I'm going to close the lever and begin removing the bald line. The Fresh Fade 1040s have a patent Stay Cool technology so that the blade and the clipper will never get hot. Now I'm going to take the half guard with the lever closed and begin removing the line that I just left behind. Still using a C motion so I don't go into the cut and leave behind a line that I don't want to. Now I'll open the lever and take the half guard all the way up into the line. The Fresh Fade 1040 also has a patent smart clip technology, which all that means is the clipper senses resistance whenever it's cutting thick or coarse hair and speeds up the motor to help get through the hair. The Fresh Fade 1040 also has an LCD display screen. It displays the minutes, so you're gonna know exactly when the clipper is going to die. It also displays the five speed settings you have to choose from. Take the number two guard with the lever closed and start removing the bulk that I don't want. And no matter how busy I get during the day, what's great about the Fresh Fade 1040s is that it has a lithium ion battery and it lasts about three times longer than traditional batteries. Now I'm going to take my fade blade and begin to bald again. Both our fade blade and our taper blade are titanium blades that are self-sharpening and rust-free. In the back, I'm coming to a point because I want the fade to have a little bit of a harsh point to it. Now I'm going to take my Fresh Fade 1040s with the lever open and start leaving behind the half line. Then I'm going to close the lever to begin removing the bald line. then I'm going to take the half guard closed and begin removing the half line. I'm having him tilt his head down so I can see the dark spots that I couldn't see previously. Still using my half guard with the lever closed, I begin flicking out to remove that line. Now I'm going to take my one guard with the lever open and begin taking the half line out. Then I'm going to take my 1.5 guard with the lever open and do the same process. Moving on to the back of the fade, I'm going to put the one guard on with the lever closed to remove any dark spots that I see. Using my JRL comb to hold back the hair while I use the two guard with the lever closed to finish the top of the fade. Now I'm going to put in the Hunter 1114 Bold Hold Tonic while the hair is wet and blow dry it in. Using my JRO Phantom Blow Dryer and a round brush, I'm going around all the edges and blowing the hair inward. I'm making sure the hair is fully dry before I put any product in. Now I'm using Hunter 1114's Fiber Gum by rubbing it all over my hands and putting it all over his hair to give it the desired look that I'm looking for. And sometimes I like using my fingers to place the hair where I want it rather than a comb to give it a more natural look. And this is the final look. I appreciate you guys watching and be on the lookout for more videos in the future.